Thank you for having me. My name is Joe. I am an autistic man. Do any other autistic people in?
Woo!
One. The rest of you, don't worry. It takes a while for the vaccines to kick in. I give it 2 more years, we'll all be autistic. It'll be a lot better. The trains will run on time. It'll be good. I say autistic, by the way. Sometimes people tell me off. There's a sort of rumour going around that's more politically correct to say person with autism, not autistic. And I like it. I like autistic. It's direct, it's all in one. It's good, yeah? Person with autism is separating the person from who they are. I don't think that's good. I like autistic. It's direct, you know? If someone works in a coffee shop, I call them a barista. I wouldn't call them a person with a theatre degree. I'd call them... Things like this, you know, there's not a lot of autistic representation. It's good to be here, because there is a thing. We don't see autistic people on TV a lot. When something on TV about us, it's never us speaking, you know? It's two groups that get to go on TV, talk about autism. You get scientists, they get to go on the news, talk about autism. I think they get things wrong more than they get things right, you know? There's a stereotype that autistic people don't understand humour and jokes. And we know where that comes from. It comes from a scientist. It comes from a scientist called Hans Asperger. He was a scientist who worked for the German government in the 1930s and 40s in Germany. He worked for the government, sort of late 1930s, early 1940s. He worked for the German government of the time in their pioneering work with disabled people. And if any of you have ever been told you've got no sense of humour by a real-life Nazi. But I'm not taking that seriously. Loads of scientists have written about that since. What an arrogant thing for a scientist to say. How have the scientists tested that? What's the experiment that's led to that conclusion? They've told some autistic people some jokes. The autistic people haven't laughed at their jokes, not even out of social politeness. And then they've added that to the diagnosis criteria. I'm not allowed to do that. I wish I could do that as a comedian. That would make my life so much easier. If I tell you all the jokes today and none of you laugh, gotta go away and think about that. Think about my delivery, think about the wording, the joke. Maybe I don't do that joke again. What I'm not allowed to do is come out here, tell a load of jokes to complete silence, walk backstage and say to the producer, oh, they didn't laugh at those jokes. I guess the only explanation is that they all had some sort of mental disability prevented them from understanding my amazing comedy. The other group you get the parents of autistic children, they get to go on the news, talk about autistic. But that's cool, there's some good parents of autistic children speaking up for their kids, you know, but I think there's a difference between speaking up for and speaking for, and I think we know the difference when we see it. And if I'm honest, some of the most upsetting things people have said to me after gigs has come from what I know is a tiny minority of parents of autistic children who believe sort of weird things about autistic people. I was at a barbecue recently. My friends have got kids, all our friends have got kids. We're all having fun at this barbecue, getting later in the day. One family's turn to leave. Little boy in the family says goodbye. This is how he says goodbye. See what you think of this, right? He goes, goodbye, kids and grown-ups. I think that's lovely. I think it's a lovely way to say goodbye. Well done, little boy. Then his mum steps in and goes, no, say it properly. The little boy goes, goodbye, kids and grown-ups. His mum says, I'm sorry about him. He has autism, but it's not severe autism. Let's unpack what's being said there. She's apologising for him saying goodbye in a way that at worst is unusual, but I think it's a great way to say goodbye. Then she's saying he has autism, but it's not severe. I hate the word severe. Not because I think all autistic people are the same, but because I don't think any of us are bad. The word severe means worse, isn't it? It really upset me, you know? I didn't say anything. I didn't want to have an argument at this barbecue, but it did upset me a lot. Maybe I should have said something, but I never do. Another reason I didn't say anything, I think this complicates it a bit. She spoke good English, but English wasn't her first language. I think it makes it a bit ruder, like telling someone what words they should be using if it's not their first language. I didn't want it to look sort of rude. She was French, but not severely French. She had a very mild form of the condition. I mean, between us, she said she was French. I couldn't see anything wrong with her. She just looked normal to me, but she said she was French, and you have to believe them, don't you? You can't say anything, can you, if you don't think they're French? But all I'm saying is, a lot of people seem to be French these days. just saying, when I was growing up, it was a very rare thing. Like, basically no one was French apart from, like, the really, really French ones. And they were all kept in patisseries. And now everyone's saying, oh, I'm French. Like they identify as French, yeah, but they haven't been properly diagnosed by an Englishman, and that's all I will count. Anyway, it's been a lot of fun. Thanks for having me. Goodbye, kids and grown-ups.